Good morning, everybody. It is a beautiful Sunday morning, and welcome to another episode of the Sunday Sketch. We have got just 1 week to go till the next Fan Art Fusion, which is my end of the month stream where I try and, sketch characters in a different style, draw or paint or whatever, but try to render them in a vastly different style than they're used to being seen in. You can go back and check some of my other videos I've done so far, Zarya and Spider-Man, this year. Zarya, Dragon Ball Z Zarya was a lot of fun. I like to try and challenge myself, push myself in different directions. So if you want to see, oh, I don't know, say you want to see that guy from Berserk in Persona Q for some reason. Go ahead and leave a comment down in the description when this video gets archived. So, without further ado, I'm just going to get started. Now, I have been playing Persona 3, actually. excuse me, sorry. I beat Persona 4, not Golden though, just plain old Persona 4, and I had been playing Persona 3 on and off. Persona 5 comes out, and I'm like, well, now I have to beat Persona 3 first, just to have that closure, because if I start another Persona game, I don't know. I mean, I doubt they're related, they don't seem to be. But I do like to wrap things up with my video games, even if it takes a while, I don't want to start Persona 5 if I haven't finished the other Persona games that I've started. So I've got like four, I think I've got like four full moon bosses to go, something like that. I don't know. No spoilers. Comment section. But it occurred to me I had this really great idea, or I thought it was a great idea, because you've got your Persona 4 protagonist who's kind of, I don't know. You know what? I should do what I always do. Pull up some good reference material. Okay. I like his haircut, the Persona 5 guy. Anyways, so you have your Persona 5 guy, and he kind of looks. A little like this number. Right? Ooh, long nose, kind of come down here. Okay, we'll call that a warm up. And then you got your Persona 3 protagonist. No, not status effects, protagonist. Thank you, Google. There we go. With an entirely different haircut, really. He's more. Kind of like this number. Right? But noticing and that they have in common, right, is they both use guns. So, you know, this guy actually uses, you know, an actual gun, and then these guys use those evoker things, which are like crazy shoot yourself in the face guns. So I thought it might be fun if I tried to do something along those lines. Because you got some really interesting character designs, and you got this, you know, related gun piece. So I'm going to try and do a little piece. I'm going to try and do it closer to Persona 5 style, just because it is really, really, what do you call it? I don't know. It's super, super stylish. You know, like, it uses a very minimal color palette, a lot of black and red and white, and then it'll throw in, you know, like, the character's hair color or something like that. But overall, that bright red is pretty rad. So, you know what? We're gonna start off with that. And then let's see. Let's see if we can find a good reference of him in the pose that I want. No, not so much. Well, that's fine. I can make up the pose if I can just, get those design elements down. Okay, so he's got this big high collar, right? Well, let's draw the pose first. I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Get excited about the the project, and then get ahead of myself. So we're just gonna draw the pose first. Do it from this angle, right? So I want to have this kind of line of action here, and then this is going to be an arm, so we're going to have sort of a pose like that.
line. And I want to have the other protagonist from Persona 3 continuing that line of action. So I gotta figure out how we're gonna bring that line of action through into the other protagonist's head, because he's gonna have his gun here. So we're gonna go ahead and do... kind of a that number. A little crouched, and I know he tends to shoot himself in the side of the head. I've played enough Persona 3 for that to know that much, but he's gonna be doing the Yukari shooting directly into the front of the face, I think is what I want him to do. Just because it continues that same through line, right? So I think that'll make for a better piece for it to like connect like that. And so he's gonna be doing something kind of like that. And again, I'll adjust poses as I feel the need. But I do want to go ahead and get started with that. And so we're going to start on Joker first, obviously. And he is super stylish. Okay, so we're gonna zoom in here. And we're gonna fade that a little. And then he does have some slick line work to him, so I'm gonna try and copy that as much as I can. Lips are a little full for him. But I want to give him kind of a confused expression. Still trying to pull off that style. Hmm. got those thick black lines on the shadows. So he's got this big old nose shadow out here. Then it's weird because not all of the shadows are that way, you know? But in any case, he's got. His eyes have that kind of sharp. That. I don't know how to do the little eyelash thing that they do. Oh, Japan. There we go. Still need to take that in more. Get it closer to the. Oops! No, don't do that. Get it closer to his nose line. There we go. Probably bring this one in more, too. Let's see, where do they draw the lines the thickest? Kind of towards the edges of things, it looks like, so. Of course, I'd probably want to give him that Joker mask anyway, huh? In which case, we're drawing. This line,
right? And then he ends up with these big black rings around his eyes.
more like that, right? Nice thing is being able to remove that when necessary. So let's go in and do the hair. I'm gonna go ahead and leave that layer off for now, just so that I can get better, like, hair reference, right? And his hair is very, very layered. So first we're gonna put his ear on, because of course he needs to have his ear. His hair actually comes down quite a ways. So we're just going to be making kind of rough shapes. Got very, very loose, very kind of wavy hair. And it all seems to kind of come from the top and back of his head. Even covers up his ear a little bit. Okay. I'm gonna try to do is kind of because of the style of this, I'm gonna try and do all of these lines kind of in that thick black, right? And then go over it and like add color and stuff in. Very specific places. So like that. Because, of course, he's got anime schoolboy chin. So more like that. And then his neck. So his ear is here. Then his neck, and he's gonna have more hair back here. It kind of curves this way. And he's got this super red shirt collar thing, but I'm going to do the rest of his body first. He's going to have the center right about there. I'd say that's a pretty decent confused look. And then we're gonna try and take his skinny, skinny Japanese schoolboy legs, and kind of work those in too. So, but he's gonna be standing in this kind of a pose here, right? So we're gonna have his abdomen. So there's his rib cage, right? Pectoral muscles would be roughly there, except he's raising his arm, so his pectoral is probably going to be stretched out like that. That's an interesting concept, is that the pectoral muscle is actually kind of attached, you know, this way and this way, kind of up around your neck almost. So when you raise your arms, your pecs, you know, should also rise with them, and kind of get stretched and deformed and all of that. So I found that to be rather interesting. But you know what? His head is a little off with the rest of his body, I feel like, in perspective, right? So we're going to go ahead and try just doing a little bit of rotation till it feels better placed. Of course, you know, not way over there. Yeah, that I think is a better angle on it. Much. So now we're gonna have to, of course, rotate the whole thing. To match that angle. And this is, again, you know, these things kinda happen. If you're, I know there are people out there who are, like, really good and get this kinda stuff, in the first try, or like, you know, the Bob Ross out there, just, again, I've been watching a lot of Bob Ross, but, you know, like, those people out there who just, like, there's the mountain, and, there's some trees and stuff, you know, they can do things like that really fast, and it's because they're, you know, practiced at it, right? I am, less practiced at drawing anime schoolboys, so that's part of the reason this is taking me longer to set up than, say, a character I'm more familiar with drawing, right? So his knee, now they got these weird, you know, skinny, and I'm terrible at legs too, but he's got these, like, skinny jeans kind of things, and I don't think Joker's outfit is too much different. Oh no, I see. It's not okay, so less the skinny jeans, but they are tapered. So I do want to set that up anyway. Regardless of how that goes. So his knee is gonna be in the front like there, right? So that's gonna be his shin bone, kind of crossing there. And then he's gonna gonna plant his foot out here. Of course, he's got these pointy shoes, but I'll get to that. And then this leg, I want to have kind of moved back a little. So he's gonna kind of come back. We're gonna put the knee in roughly the same space, right? And then this foot, or this leg, is gonna come and be turned away, kind of planted and shifted away from the target he's shooting at, right? So he's gonna kind of be that way. And actually, I should bring this leg up further, since this is the leg that he's gonna be putting a lot more weight on for stability. Kind of bring that, work that out. And then plant the foot slightly forward, right? Maybe, hopefully. I'll tweak it. You know what? As a matter of fact, I think it's probably the back leg that I'm having problems with, not the front leg, because the front leg should be fine with proportions and everything. You know, you don't want to throw it off. I'm not like an expert, I'm just an art student, but I think that his leg would be fine planting here. And so this back leg should be shifted more into the background, which means we need to take a transform and wrong transform. I actually think I want a perspective transform, right? So in this program I'm using, that's going to be a mesh transform, and that kind of treats it like a 3D object, so I can like pull at this mesh, right, and kind of wiggle it into place. As a 3D object. And bam! Back leg is more back. And then I can just come in here and make some proportions adjustments as I see fit. Seems workable. Seems like a workable pose. Kind of long in the torso, I feel like, but I don't know. Maybe we bring it up a little. First, I'm drawing at an angle that I'm not really used to, and second, anime characters tend to have really weird proportions anyway, I feel like. So let's try that. That looks better, you know. Space between here and here, and here and here. That could work. Alright. And then, of course, the long arms. Obviously much more comfortable drawing arms than I am legs. Um Except those, that arm isn't nearly long enough. Because what you want to do is you want to have your arm kind of come mid-thigh, right? So... And then it's going to swing up. So actually, that's not a bad arc. Because if this were down, it'd be... So maybe it's just the elbow position, maybe? And then the hand would be about here, so you want to go up, up. Yeah, let's move the elbow and the hand out a little bit. So move this out there, roughly, and then go into the wrist. And another trick is that I think the, if I'm remembering, the arm should kind of be also the length of, like, from the knee to the foot, I think, something like that. Ooh, sorry, excuse me. Having some issues with the weather. You know, let's try building it up from a skeleton first, like this arm, right? So we have that shoulder point here, and we're going to have that arm be roughly that long. That looks a little more natural, I think. So we have the wrist there. That's fine. Yeah, that looks much better. Okay. So then on top of that, we're gonna have the whole Joker getup, right? And... starters, we want to have, want to start out by blocking out some more of the costume, starting with, I believe, his magnificent collar. There we go. And he's got this awesome waistcoat deal going on. And then his pants are a little interesting because they're kind of loose through here. And then they bunch up. Or they taper, rather. They don't really bunch. then he's got these pointy shoes with heels on them. Oh, he's got heels on. That's going to change the whole... It's interesting that he's got heels on, actually, but that's going to change the whole presentation of the foot and the leg, really, because then you're putting this thing back here. It's going to push this all up a little. So then when he bends at the knee, it's going to be more... I want to say more popped out, but I gotta figure out the kind of physics there or whatever. And then, of course, with this foot, he's gonna have the heel here. And then this shoe is gonna be pointy, kind of in this direction. Kind of these heel boots. Well, actually, it looks like the cuff of the boot is a little higher than that, so more like up here. Okay, then we're going to bring this line down here, and that is just going to go straight into his magnificent coattails, as he has. I do wonder, though, because it looks like, from the official art, it almost looks like he has multiple coattails. Let's see if I can find any other strong reference points for him. Yeah, it definitely looks like he's got three coattails. More like a trench coat in the back there. It's an interesting design. Okay. So that's cool. So he's actually got three coattail-like things going on back there. And they are super, super long. It's interesting, I thought it was like more like a dinner jacket kind of thing, because of the pocket square. He's got he totally has a pocket square. But it is a lot more like a leather jacket kind of situation. I mean, he totally does have a pocket square, but it's less of a tuxedo jacket and more like a leather jacket that's just fancy and kind of fashioned after a tuxedo jacket. Which, again, is a super red concept. It's like Matrix and James Bond at the same time. Definitely a little unconventional, I would think. So then this ends in this big old cuff. Oh, it actually ends way further up, so. Big old cuff, right? And then here's the tricky part, because he's got pointed shoulders, right? And so whenever you have a jacket with square shoulders, you get this weird wrinkle when you if you raise your arm too high. And then again, the big old cuff. Right, so turn that layer off. Looks jokery. I mean, you know, put that on and probably make him smile more. You know what? Let's give him a smile. It'll be fine. I'm not worried. Joker smile. The problem is his Joker smiles, like when he smiles as Joker, it looks really, really crazy. Like I've seen some of those in-game, like that in-game, like when he, you know, when you finish somebody off in a holdup or whatever, and he totally looks like he's gonna murder some people. I mean, you know, you kind of just got finished murdering people in the case of a holdup. If you went for the all-out attack, of course. I don't think I draw that smile very well. Maybe if I raise it up some more, make it a little bigger. How about that? Let's try that. almost good. There we go, that looks better. I mean, it looks a lot creepier, but it looks better. Okay, so now I'm just gonna take my marker tool and I'm just gonna block all of this in. You know, more or less. Because again, we're trying to capture that really super stylized look, right? Oh yeah, and he's got this really rad, like, collar to his waistcoat. I actually really love most of the Phantom Thieves' costume design. Most of them, not all of them. Like, and I feel like I'm probably gonna get some flack for this, but like, I think Anne's could be a little more interesting. I understand that she's, you know, rebelling, and so her form of rebellion is, like, I don't know, a sexy Catwoman or something. I haven't played through the game yet. But I just think that it could be more, I don't know, more developed maybe? Like, I'll have to look at it again. But it's just a cat mask and a cat suit, right? Like, sorry. Like, Joker's got this great gentleman thief thing going on. Skull looks awesome. He looks like a biker gang dude. Foxes is a little weird. I mean, the fox mask is really cool. Because it is very artsy looking. And I know he's a I know that he's some kind of a painter. And so having his costume be all artistic and stuff also is pretty cool. But he sort of looks like a disco guy for some reason. So he's the disco fox. So we've got that all blocked in. Now the gloves, they keep that nice red color for these you know, stylized images and things, but I'm gonna go ahead and block that in too. I saved that for last just because it seemed right. And then his face is gonna be, you know, blocked in mostly white. Or very pale, anyway. Because that's another thing that happens in this really high stylized version. Is that, you know, practically everything else can be white. And then you end up having these bright color spots of color, right? So we're actually gonna do a muted skin tone. I'm gonna try to anyway. And we're already starting to get the look we're going for. Starting to. I mean, it's not quite there yet, obviously, but it's starting to get there. Need to be a little more saturated than that. And a little darker. No, that's too dark. A little jaundiced, so let's take it into more of an orange. It's a little better. There we go. There we go, that's much better. And then we gotta get the brown for his hair. This is all gonna go on a layer on top of this black. See how much of this line we can do without. Okay, that's fine. So, we're gonna come up here. And I gotta give him more white on his mask, obviously. That's not right. Oh, well, this is where the mask would go. Well, let's put it here. Red eyes, of course. Because for some reason he's got red eyes. And then the brown hair. This is where it gets a little weird. Or not weird necessarily. Probably use that word too much, but it gets tricky. Because I want to do the brown, it's got to be bright enough, right? Like, that's actually a pretty good brown. But then it's got to be subtle enough. Right, to just give impression of color, but also give an impression of like texture and shape, you know? That's probably too much. That's good there. So that's probably all I can afford to do there to keep it looking right aesthetically. Which again just makes the job all that much more difficult, right? Of course, I do have to bring some of his mask forward, right? So we've got to do... go back in with the white. Because otherwise, you know, you lose some of your that Joker look, I guess. For lack of a better term, the Joker look. And of course, not the Mark Hamill or various other people who have played Batman's Joker. You know, that's actually kind of a funny issue for me, because, you know, some people are like, Heath Ledger's an amazing Joker or whatever, but in my brain, Mark Hamill's the Joker, and that's just that. Anywho, now we're going to come in and take, like, a gray, right? And we're going to add... just enough definition to the coat. Again, we can't add too much, right? And it probably has to respond to just one direction of light. And I think I should probably be doing this on another layer. Yeah. So, just responding to one direction of light, very minimalistic. Or as much as we can, minimalistic. Probably just that. Then, because I think the shape is pretty well defined through here. Gotta do the pants. Let's mute that a little bit so we can come in to wherever I put that layer. There we go. There it is. And define the shape of the pants. Or at least where the light's gonna hit it. Like that. Seemed good. Ooh. There you go. Yeah, you kind of get the idea of the jacket there. Should probably just do this whole shape here. Even though barely any light's gonna hit it. Shape definition is kind of important. So you can tell, you know, where his ass is and stuff like that. I think I'm gonna go ahead and blur this out a little bit, though. Oh. That's why it wasn't doing anything that I wanted it to. Keeping track of my layers. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's kind of weird. Taking just a dark color there would probably do the trick. So if we just come in here, whoops. Do a tonal adjustment. That'll probably have the same effect that I want, which Which is exactly right. Yes. All right. Cool. So we have. Oof. This line has got to go. It's much better. Fewer lines for this style, I think, are what I need to do. That works. Okay, mostly. Might have to just change the color of his pants altogether, because otherwise you lose... Like, it ends up looking like a big black blob down there, you know? Well, in any case, we are... I think more or less ready to do the gloves. I should put the pocket square in, though. Because that is one of the colored elements. And it's sort of this off-white color. I'm just gonna go ahead and I think I've got everything where I want it to be. There is an issue with it being like really, really sketchy. So what I'm gonna do is just like clean up all the lines. But I'll do that later. First off, the next thing I want to do is the red in the gloves. Which is that bright red. But it does have plenty of black around it, too. Kind of just coming in with my pencil and just arranging the colors the way they would be. You know, when I fill it in this way, it does still look like a fist, but it also sort of looks like a spray paint kind of a stencil, right? It's kind of weird. I might try something like that someday. Another stylistic challenge. Well, this has turned out to be a lot more difficult than I anticipated. You know, it's a lot of basic shapes and colors and stuff, but we are already... over an hour, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up here. I kind of shared the concept, so I'm pleased enough with that. And I gotta clean up the lines,
But I'm actually pretty pleased at how this came out for a first try. Thanks for tuning in. If you want to see my fan art fusion challenge, you want to see a particular character, like, I don't know, maybe you want to see me draw a bird or something, just leave a comment when this video goes up, and next weekend I will be doing my fan art fusion. So far, I haven't gotten a lot of feedback, but people really seem to like the Revali video, so I will probably end up doing something with one of the Zelda champions, and trying them in another style. So, in any case, thanks for tuning in. Hope you have a good Sunday, and I will see you all next time. Bye.